Morning, student. In previous class, I discussed about impact of colonial policy on Indian economy. By the time India won its independence in 1947, the impact of around 190 years of British colonial rule was already showing on all aspects of Indian economy. Through all this discussion in my previous video, you came to know about how British government exploited the Indian economy, not especially in different sector I have already discussed. Through discussion, we come to know that the per capita income of our country was very low during colonial period. Majority of the population, around more than 75% population, are dependent on agriculture. The Jamindari system, which was very exploitative, was prevalent in our country. Traditional method of cultivation was farmers were producing crops by traditional method of cultivation. Britishers never bothered about to introduce modern technique of farming. High frequency of famines, the rate of famines was frequent in our country, and destruction of Indian handicraft industries, the handicraft industry which was very famous in our country, the British's policy exploited our handicraft industries. Inadequate industrialization, the British's never bothered about the development of industry of this country. Although they systematically destroyed small-scale industry, which was few population were dependent on a small-scale industry due to British policies, these small-scale industries were also destroyed. The hostile policy of British government led to the complete ruin of Indian economy. The economic policy pursued by the colonial government in India were concerned more with the protection and promotion of their own economic interest than with the development of Indian economy. Their main motive was to drain out the wealth and resources from their country and to develop their own their respective country, that is Britain. Even though the colonial period had been exploitative, but it has a positive aspect also. Today, I will discuss about positive contribution of the British rule through the following points. First one is self-sufficiency in food grain production. Commercialization of agriculture initiated by British government resulted in self-sufficiency in food grain production. British commercialized the agriculture. They focused more on cash crop, which are very much demanded in European country. Through the with the help of cash crop, farmers were able to earn more money. Second one is better means of transportation. Development of road, railway provided cheap and rapid transport system and opened up new opportunities of economic and social growth. Third is shift of monetary economy. British rule helped Indian economy to shift from barter system of exchange. Barter system of exchange means exchange of goods for goods, to monetary system of exchange. Next one is effective administrative setup. The British government had an efficient administrative system which served as a ready reckoner for Indian politicians. With the help of effective administration, British was able to control the freedom movement also. Next is check on famines. Famines which was very frequent in our country, with the help of infrastructure development like roads and railways, British were able to control famines. Roads and railways work as a great check on the occurrence of and impact of famines, as food supplies could be transported to the affected areas in case of droughts. These are the positive effect of British rule also. So these things we cannot deny. Yeah. Now end of the discussion on this chapter, that is Indian economy on the eve of independence. Now students, I would suggest all of you to make answer of few questions, and these question I am giving you. These are the questions. The question number one is, discuss the state of India's foreign trade during the colonial rule. Second is, describe the salient features of India's occupational structure during British period. Third one is, British rule adversely hampered the industrial sector of India. Do you agree with this view? Give reason in support of your answer. And fourth is, briefly discuss the state of infrastructural facility during the British period. Students, you have to answer or make notes on these questions. I will check all those questions in next class.